Well, new experiences doesn't always mean good things. I mean, I've never experienced something like this before. So I went to work. I always park on the side street Pine in between Central and Gold because it's free parking here and it's right next to campus. So I just walk right onto campus. And so I parked this morning, went to work. And then when I came back after work, I came to find my truck and everything looked fine from the outside. But then when I opened the door, everything inside was, I kind of cleaned it up already, but it was all trashed and everything. And I was like, what the heck? I noticed that the passenger side door was unlocked. So I went around to the passenger side, you know, to look at it, to be like, okay, what the heck? And no damage really, but all the weather stripping was peeled off. So obviously someone jimmied the lock, popped it in there, popped it open. And, oh, here comes the tow truck. Needless to say, someone broke in and tried to steal my car. So you can see here, the damage to the ignition, but they didn't get very far and they gave up and ran out. Didn't steal anything. Cologne, passes, you know, all my stuff for the tire changing is still here. Even all my radio and everything. They didn't steal nothing. They tried to steal the car and failed and ran like hell, I guess. But at least it's not too bad. At least I have the money to save it, that I saved up for it now. Yeah, so, I mean, it came out pretty good for someone trying to steal my car. Hopefully the damages aren't too much to repair, but I'll just have to find some easier way to get around town for the next couple days. And of course, it's right before Labor Day weekend, so I guess I ain't going anywhere for a while. But thank God for the garage, man. You do towing and take the car right there. It's beautiful. So minus the truck dealie this week, there was actually some really good things that happened this week. Like, for once, my new custom masks came in. I got check eye area, followed by the network demon as well. So, because I was tired of wearing my one that said be kind, work from home, because I was feeling like a hypocrite since I was still working on campus.
So, of course, what would the week be without me also showing you guys some other stuff that I've been working on outside of my custom shirts and masks and whatnot? And so this is actually going to remind you of a vlog I had earlier this year. And I've just been messing around with it more. And so without further ado, hello, guys. It's me, the Network Demon. Yeah, so I was messing around with the character animator on Adobe more, and I decided to actually animate this character for mostly one specific reason. But the one thing is I got to mess around with it, and I'm actually understanding the program a lot more. And as you can actually see, I have a lot of good moving parts. So I got the eyebrow that moves up and down when I move my eyebrows up and down. If I look left, if I look up, if I look down, if I look to the right, you know, it all looks pretty well. It's a little off, but well, you can't get everything right. The mouth seemed to be working okay. Of course, this is actually capturing in real time. So unlike the last video I did where I pre-recorded something and then played back the audio for it to then sync up perfectly, this is actually being registered in real time. So what that means is using the plugin that I downloaded for OBS and using the NewTek virtual input that I put on my computer, I can actually send the animation and the real-time movements to any program in real time. And yes, that does mean that I can actually send this to something like Zoom. So if I'm on a meeting at work, I could technically use this avatar as my character talking to the people in the meeting. And this is all they'll see, is just my animated, you know, Network Demon character. And I think that's kind of cool. But the main reason I did it was primarily for this. So I started Twitch streaming this week again. I did a couple streams earlier this week. And of course, as you know, most Twitch streamers will put, you know, themselves just in a box or with a green screen, just showing themselves on camera in the corner. So I think that's boring. So what I decided to do was see if I could create this avatar that I can literally just have in the corner of my broadcast the whole time while I'm doing my stream. It definitely saves up room because, as you can see, it's just him. So there's no box around him or anything, so you can see what's behind him. And it just looks kind of neat, you know, so people, instead of watching me and looking at my ugly mug, they'll be looking at the Network Demon. And I still think that's amazing too, the fact that he was reached out
to actually compose that stuff, because mostly for Super Smash Brothers stuff, they actually have someone there locally in Japan do all the remixes for it. So, like, he was the first ever Western, like, composer to actually do stuff for Super Smash Brothers.
And since he's also the main profile picture of my Twitch stream, it kind of makes sense. Might as well just, you know, have it all mixed together. I might even change my streaming name to The Network Demon instead of being BiggieWhite75, which I always am.
So, fun little detour on Sunday. I wake up this morning, ready to film my vlog, and I go and see that my cats are out of food, and then I'm like, oh shoot, like, I need to refill their bowl. Went into the sink, I don't have any more cat food. And I was like, oh shoot, I gotta run down to the store to get some more cat food real quick before I go to lunch with the family. And I was like, oh shoot, I don't have a truck. So I was like, well, maybe if I take my backpack and my bike, I can get down there fast enough and get it. So I pull out my bike, and the tire's flat. It wasn't flat last night, so obviously last night I punctured a hole in it somewhere. And so I refilled it, so hopefully it'll last me the way home as well, but so far, quite an interesting morning.
So I'm still waiting on my new shirt to come in too. It's supposed to come in today. I was hoping it was gonna come in before the vlog releases, but you can probably see it on Instagram because I'll probably post it on there once I get it. But I'm really excited about that. This week has been just like a week of custom designs and all sorts of cool things coming into play. So, but overall, I think it was a pretty jam-packed, busy week. Sorry, I'm exhausted. I'm riding my bike because of the cats, as I said in the earlier part. So next week, of course, it's Labor Day weekend, so we have Monday off, which is great. Probably gonna do some studio work though, even though you're not supposed to be working on Labor Day, but it should be, you know, fun. But yeah, we'll see you about next week to see what comes up. And anyways, that's all I got for you guys. And until next time, I'll see you later.